It's a cooking show where two of the most extreme cultures on earth collide. Traditional owners welcome us to their country and share their secrets of survival.
All right, Jamie, what are we cooking today?
Jamie Giapparulla is a trained chef with international fine dining qualifications.
There's lots of proteins, lots of fats, so they can sustain your diet if you are stuck in the bush and you do come across them.
My name's Rachel, but out here they call me Napanunka.
Napanunka!
I'll take you on a journey that goes beyond bush tucker.
Numpa Jimpa has just brought us to this waterhole. She said she came here with her family when they were living in the early days, before white fellas, hey?
In each episode, we travel to a new region of Australia's most spectacular, remote Aboriginal country. In his kitchen, Jamie combines his two passions in life.
So which did he grab risotto?
Yep, these lovely guys right here.
An exhilarating and delicious combination of hunting and gathering with the art of fine dining.
Okay, what we've got here is the big bulge in the root where the witchetty grubs are burrowed in. This is basically what we're chasing at the moment, is these, which is our witchetty grub. In its natural state, it's only little, but still very edible, very nice.
Oh, look! Hello! Aren't you cute?
I cannot believe Jamie is going to make me eat something like that.
Now, don't be a wuss, can't just smash it down. Raw eggs, no big deal.
I don't mind eating lots of weird and wonderful foods, but there's just something about...
It's a worm.
Yeah, but look.
Yeah, but look.
It's looking at me.
Eat it. Just do it. Just swallow it. Don't crunch. Just swallow. Obviously, Rachel would have died a slow death in the desert. Okay, Rachel, while I'm sort of dealing with the risotto, can you take these over to the Aboriginal ladies and get them to cook them in the coals for us, please?
No worries.
Mavis, can we cook these? Can you come and show me? Cook them up.
Cook
them up. Just really quick. In the coals like that for probably 5 minutes. And each witchetty grub swells up and starts to bubble and squeak.
We're going to have yelka, which is our bush onion.
They're little onions, aren't they?
Yeah, I think it'd be a real bugger if you're trying to make onion rings out of them.
This is bush onion, hey?
Oh, wow. Yelka.
Okay, so here that's some green yalga. That's some fresh green yalga. This dry stuff, that's the stuff we're looking for. When we start digging here, that's a good one.
Yeah.
We start digging up, and under here, you'll find bush onions. There, that's one there. I would never ever be able to find these again without the help of these old women.
They don't traditionally bleed their animals like Europeans do. They leave all the blood in the meat, so it's very high in iron. Being kangaroo, it's got a low fat content as well, so the kangaroo meat itself is quite healthy.
Makalari!
And you'll take home kitchen tips guaranteed to give that five-star edge to your own home-cooked meals.
Kangaroo fillet, bush tomato mayonnaise and pigweed.
And all the hard work that they go to get this little ant. The sweet taste of this honey is well worth it. I expect it to be really watery, but it is just like honey out of a jar. It's beautiful. Jamie is gonna love what we've collected here.
But for Jamie, presentation is everything.
Prefer rolls filled with honey ant custard.
No, we can mash this like a potato, hey? Cook it with fire. What's it called?
Katudari.
Katudari. How does that look, Jamie?
Adventure.
Yeah, we're going hunting.
Travel.
Chill. It's just a cocoon.
We can't cook you. We're not going to cook you.
Your risotto rice is going to absorb your liquid a lot faster if it's hot.
Two worlds, the essence of Australia.
So there's two ways to find a goanna. One is to see the goanna and they chant to it. Then it lays its head down. Uparu, uparu.
Oya uparu. Ulpuru.
Ah, sorry. Ulpuru. Yoko. Ulpuru, ulpuru. And the goanna stops dead in its tracks.
Big goanna.
Ah, the printy. These are the big goannas. Then you creep up to it, chanting ulpuru. Knock it on its head. Gone. The other way, you follow its tracks like here.
Camels here. Camels.
They're collecting little bush tomatoes for our dinner. Sweet. Really sweet. And once we've got all the supplies, Jamie works his magic.
That's our pigweed.
So emu liver pate.
It's a red meat bird. We've taken the liver out of the emu and produced pate.
That is so good.
So what we've got here is a wild lemongrass pate. This here in the bush is what we call wild lemongrass. Very fragrant, very fresh.
The complete series will take you on a culinary tour of Australia's most extraordinary landscapes. Queensland's rainforests, Arnhem Land, Tiwi Islands, Central Desert, the Kimberley's Bungle Bungles, right through to the northwest corner, Broome.
That is gourmet. Gourmet bush pate right there. Okay, so now we're serving up. Beautiful.
Okay, we're going to serve up our risotto. With our bush onions, our witchetty grubs in it.
Unbelievable. Jamie Giuparoli, you've outdone yourself.
I've been moved by the wind upon the waters and the shadows as the leaves blown. When that old wind moans on a weary winter Sunday, like a friend that keeps on knocking at my home.
It's been exhilarating and hard work. The reward? We can sit, taste and enjoy the fusion of two very different worlds.